欲望不然哈就生成起来。那么只有呢从高阶的布线者呢去聆听哈利卡卡，那么我们会有一种呢达拉玛卡提的情感，也就是皈依的情感。我们会觉得哦，克什纳会救我的，我会做呢对我的父爱有利的东西，我再会避开呢那些呢不利于我父爱的东西。因为对克什纳和咕噜这种皈依的情感，那么呢就是说我们就能得到呢逐渐的哈得到发展了其他的阶段，从斯拉达开始啊到巴宣克利亚，然后呢就是执行奉献服务哈，还有到阿纳斯尼维提，就是铲除各种恶习啊，啊到迪斯坦拉提到发等等哈这些情感。那么对克什如果呢没有呢咕噜和克什的仁慈的话呢，我们就不可能获得高阶的涟漪的。因为 Krishna 的仁慈是因为呢咕噜的祈祷，当咕噜祈祷的时候你就能得到 Krishna 的恩典。
In this world there are very rare gurus. How we can recognize that he is your guru or qualified guru? Very hard.But our Vedas, Puran, and especially Srimad Bhagavat has told the symptoms of a pure guru. What is the symptom of a pure guru? Srimad Bhaktivedanta.Madhava Maharaj Vaishnava Maharaj
那么刚才呢徐德姑也提到哈，在这个世界上呢我们是很难得到纯粹的咕噜，也就纯粹的奉献者哈作为一个咕噜的。那么在给达经在布拉纳经哈在徐马巴巴塔圣典佛教瓦堂呢提到了这些呢纯粹的咕噜的他们的征兆。
ॐ अजयं श्रीमरांजस्य गणंजनाशलाकया चक्षुर्मितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वांशिकापत्रुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यश्च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः First of all, before speaking, I wish to offer my most humble dandaka pranams at the lotus feet of my beloved spiritual master.
Can you speak Chinese?
No, unfortunately not Sri Gurudeva. Just Sri Gurudeva. Sri Gurudeva's order that we tell the symptoms of the pure guru, how we can recognize, how Shastra has told what those symptoms are.
那首先我向我心爱的灵性导师莲花族呢致以了礼拜。那么Sri Gurudeva叫我呢讲述呢纯粹的咕噜他的征兆在经典里面提到的。
The scriptures tell us there are three main symptoms by which we can tell the pure devotee, the bona fide guru.
那么经典里面提到了哈，一个呢纯正无为的灵性导师呢，咕噜的话呢，他具有了三个的征兆。
He has no material attachments or desires.
第一呢是他没有任何的哈物质的依附和欲望。
No interest whatsoever in anything of this material world.
那么对于这个世界哈，这个尘世间的东西的话呢，哈，没有兴趣。
Nothing can attract him in this world.
这个世界的没有任何东西可以吸引得了他。
Not even in his mind does anything ever attract him.
那么甚至他心里面哈都没有这种东西的哈，这个吸引力的存在的这东西。
And he is completely, absolutely familiar with Shastra, with the revealed scriptures.
那么第二呢是呢，对呢启示经典的话呢哈，完全的通晓。
And he can explain them in such a completely thorough way that anyone who has any question or any doubt, he can remove it completely. They will understand.
他以完全透彻的方式哈，阐述经典，任何人有疑问的话呢，都可以呢消除。
These two symptoms of the three are considered to be external things. They are very somewhat, although very rare.Easier to see in him.
那么的话呢，这刚才提到这两个哈征兆的话呢，属于外在的征兆， 那么尽管的话，就是说也是很罕有的拥有这两项征兆，但是呢，这是可以辨识、可以看出来的。
We can see relatively easily if someone has material desires or attachments.
我们可以呢，就是说比较容易的看出一个人哈是否呢有一些哈物质的欲望或者是依附。
If someone does or does not know Shastra, it becomes evident quite quickly. They cannot satisfy, they cannot answer our questions.
还有呢，就是一个人如果呢不精通经典的话呢，他不能够呢令我满意哈，就是不能够呢让我们哈铲除疑惑的。
But the third symptom of bona fide guru is very difficult to perceive.
但是呢，第三个哈，一个真正的灵性老师，第三个征兆呢是非常难以哈察觉的。
That is that he has fully realized his relationship, his service with the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna.
那就是呢，他与主 Krishna 哈 ，Sri Krishna 的话呢哈，完全觉悟到跟他的关系以及对他的服务。
He is fully aware of his eternal identity and relationship and service to the Supreme Lord Sri Sri Radha Govinda.
那么他也呢哈，完全呢自觉的话呢，自己呢对 Sri Sri Radha Govinda 哈这个服务。
And with that loving mood of service to the divine couple that is always flowing in his heart, by the association of such a guru.It may be reflected into our heart.
那么，藉由这样的一个孤独的哈这个联谊的话呢，那么他内心的情感会投射到哈他的弟子或门徒心中。
But who can perceive this?
那么谁能够呢哈察觉到这种情感的流露呢？哦，这是非常困难的。
Neophyte devotee like myself, you cannot perceive.
那么，对于一个初阶奉献者哈
，How to tell?
像我这样子的哈，那么我怎能够知道呢
？More advanced persons.That are being removed from the influence of the three modes of material nature, then they will be able to. As they come into that, into their service, into their association, hearing Harikatha from them.
如果呢哈，修为高一点的人的话呢哈，如果他能够在这种纯粹奉献者的哈听，从他那处聆听，或者是呢服务他的话呢，他能够感受到他内心这种情感。
These three are the symptoms of the bona fide guru.
所以呢，刚才讲到三点的话呢，是一个哈、哦、真实无为的灵性导师他的征兆。
And scripture says that we should test to see whether we see these symptoms.
那么经典也提到了哈、哦，一个弟子的话呢，要去哈、哦、去呢哈、哦、考验哈、哦、这位导师哈、哦，看看有没有这三种。
So to the best of our ability, we will look.
那么也是尽我们能力哈、哦，我们去呢哈、哦、查知这点。
Still.Only by that bona fide Guru's causeless mercy can anything be revealed to us. We can even recognize any of these three characteristics in him at all.
那么其实也是藉由这样的位灵性老师的他的恩典的话呢，这些东西才能够向我们内心揭示的。因为实际上我们可能没有能力甚至认出这三样品质里面其中一点。
I'd just like to add one thing that Shrivade was told.You can find it in one very excellent book of his. We hope to have translated to Chinese soon, called Pinnacle of Devotion.
那么我想添加一点哈，就说呢，像郭队呢哈，在痛爱之巅哈这本书呢哈，我希望很快能够翻译成中文哈，这里面提到一些东西。
That when a devotee is praying from his heart, that Krishna will send him help.
当一个奉献者在他内心祈祷的时候呢 ，Krishna 会呢帮忙的。
He wants to serve Krishna, but he realizes he cannot. He needs help.
那么他想服务 Krishna， 但是觉得哈自己做不到，所以他想得到帮助。
Praying like that from the heart with tears, then Krishna sends bona fide spiritual master.
当他内心哈流泪啊去祈祷的时候，那么 Krishna 就把呢哈真正的灵性导师呢哈派过来了。
We are very fortunate to have come into such association.
所以呢，我们很幸运来到了这种的哈联谊之中。
I'm so proud of you, Mr. Krishna Deva.
Now, we see that Guru is essential. Without Guru, bhakti cannot be.Even we see Krishna being Supreme Personality of Godhead, He has also Guru. Sri Ramchandra, He has also Guru Vasishtha. Even Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has Guru Ishwarpuri, why they are corrupt guru. But given to teach other general person, that without the help of guru, without the service of guru, you cannot have bhakti. And without bhakti, you cannot be happy. So, we see in Srimad Bhagavatam that Vyasadeva is Narayan, Satyavesh of Narayan. He divided Vedas in four parts and he took the aspect of all the Vedas and made Brahma Sutra, one book. It was very difficult to understand. So he made Puran for understanding the Sutra. He made Mahabharata for all. But even it was very hard to know Brahma Sutra. And finally, he was repenting that I have done so much, but I am not happy. My soul is not happy. What should I do? Why not happy? I don't know. In the meantime, Nar Devasi Nar came there. And what happened? Yo, just so they speak.
那么接受Guru对我们的修行来说呢是最主要的，也有Guru的帮助的话呢是不可能有Bhakti的。像师尊主Bhagavan Krishna、Surama，那么他们都有Guru，那么Rama的Guru的话呢是Vasistha Muni，Mahaprabhu的话呢也接受了Iswaruni，Iswaruni Path接作为呢Guru。那么尽管他们都是呢宇宙Guru，加个Guru，但是为了教导众生，他们都接受了灵性老师。 没有对Guru的服务或者说没有呢Guru的帮助的话呢是不可能得到 Krishna Bhakti 的，而没有呢 Bhakti 的话呢我们也得不到任何的帮助。那么圣眼佛教法坛的编撰者 Ayanspay，那么他呢是哈祖玛雅的这个门徒，那么他将韦达经呢分为呢四部分，并且将精华部分呢提炼为呢 Brahma Sutra， 但是 Brahma Sutra 非常难以人明白，所以他呢哈将此的话呢。
ముఖం గడజుదాక్షలం పొంగుం లంగైతేగిరిం యత్కృపాతమహం వందే శ్రీగురుం దినతరమి. I offer my most humble obeisances to the lotus feet of my Diksha Guru's Divine Grace on Vishnupad Shri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, and to the lotus feet of my Siksha Gurus and Guardians, Nitalila Pravishnam Vishnupad Shri Srimad Gaurabhanda Swami Maharaj, Nitalila Pravishnam Vishnupad Shri Srimad A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada, and to the Siddhani Sanyasikan, my Gurujan, disciples of Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, my God brothers and God sisters, and all the guests here, my humble friend of pranams to all of you.
首先我向我亲爱的灵性导师，Shri 向我的虚实灵性导师，Shri
Govinda Maharaj的莲花主顶拜，向在座的各位的Shri Govinda的门徒以及 Vaishnava Vaishnava的顶拜。 Krishna appears as Guru also in the heart of all living entities as Chaitya Guru, residing in the heart.
Krishna的话呢，也显现在众生心中，以Chaitya Guru内在Guru的话呢形象展示。
But it's this guru that leads us to the bona fide spiritual master. And at this time, Sri Gurudev is explaining the Leela of how Mahamuni Veda Vyasadeva, who is Sita Goswami and Srimad Bhagavatam, has said that he is an incarnation Shaktivesh avatar of the Supreme Lord Himself. He had taken the Vedas, divided into four. Gurudev explained all this, but still there was some despondency. He was still somewhat unhappy. And
那么呢刚才呢呃是的姑爷讲到了哈，原来是被呃是呢主的一个能量状态化身，那么他呢将给他金分为四部分，但是依然不高兴，所以呢在这个时候哈讲到了这一点。Because
Veda Vyasade is an empowered incarnation of the Lord Himself. Certainly He knows all things. He is a self-realized soul.
那么Veda Vyasa的话呢哈，也是主的非常有能力的哈能量的一个化身之一啊。
So when he was meditating on what was the cause, even though he had thought so very mercifully about the condition of all the living energies in this world, how to deliver them through explaining the Vedas, dividing the Vedas, writing Vedanta Sutra, Mahabharata, and all these literatures only to save the conditioned souls in this world, how merciful he is.
想象好他呢，为了呢，就是救赎众生的话呢，天状美拉经哈，天状普拉那经，以及呢好其他的普拉那苏舍等等经典，那么他也是呢哈对众生呢哈，还有这种呢哈非名之意。But
the age of Kali is approaching, and people in this age are very short-lived. They have very small intelligence. It's difficult for them to understand what Vedavyasa had written in the Vedas, and also in the Vedas there's so much description. In the Karmakanda and Jnanakanda sections about materialistic activity, how to gradually develop, and also about moksha, about liberation.
但是的话呢，卡利年代的众生的话呢，短寿哈，没有智慧，所以的话呢，尽管韦达经里面哈，就是他们难以明白韦达经里面传达的意思，尤其是呢哈，Karmakanda和呢Jnanakanda，就是知识之故和业报之故里面一些知识。So
when a sincere disciple just prays within the core of his heart and cries for guidance from Krishna, then Krishna most mercifully appears outside and before him as the liberated devotee, the spiritual master. So while Veda Vyasa is contemplating all these things, on the bank of the holy river, while meditating, he got some realization that he had not fully described the wonderful, beautiful pastimes of Sri Krishna in his previous
literatures.
At that time, his spiritual master appeared before him, Sri Narad Muni.
那么当时的话呢，他的灵性导师Narada Muni呢显现在他面前。Narada Muni
is directly the son of Lord Brahma, the creator of the universe.
Narada Muni呢是主 Brahma 的这个儿子，他是这个宇宙的创造者。And
one of the first and most prominent disciples of Lord Brahma.
也是主 Brahma 的最主要的门徒之一。And
Brahma himself accepted Sri Krishna as his guru.
那么呢，主 Brahma 的话呢，也接受了 Krishna 作为他的guru。
So Narada Muni is also described as Siddhartha.